And I was actually going to get on the air and tell you mission accomplished, unlike President Bush, who declared mission accomplished and wasn't accomplished.
I feel like
completed a mission. My mission was, I wasn't even sure exactly what the mission was, but to see Sirius grow and to see it become a full company and to watch this little form of media that was barely a business, 600,000 subscribers when we came here. And within 4 years, we have seen not only satellite radio grow in prominence to 35 million people using it, subscribing, but we saw a company that went from 600,000 subscribers to 18, 19 million subscribers, and with 35 million users, conservatively. And I think this is the first year they've actually posted a profit. Isn't that something?
That's beautiful.
Yeah, isn't that what Mel announced recently? Steve, you're a newsman.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't have the figure.
Am I right? This was the first year they posted a profit.
Yeah, cash flow positive, I think.
Cash flow positive. And I feel we've accomplished something here that is quite remarkable. Really, really remarkable. And mission accomplished. That's it. I'm declaring it accomplished. But no matter what happens from here on in, this medium is going to survive. I can tell you that. And it's a viable business. And when I met with Leon Black and Mark Rowan and Scott Greenstein, when I signed on to this company, I sat with Leon and I sat in his home. And he said to me, what do you think? If you come over here, what do you think is going to happen? I said, Leon, if you hire me, I'll tell you exactly what's going to happen. The other guys will be out of business and you will win. And everybody kind of chuckled. I said, I'm not joking. I'm not fucking with any of you. You bring me into this company, you will be winners. If you don't, you'll go bankrupt. And you will win. Now, at the time, XM had, I don't know how many millions of subscribers.
Five, I think.
5 million to their 600,000, and everyone was laughing. Even XM was laughing at me. I told them the same thing, because they asked me, what do you think will happen? I said, Sirius will be out of business. You'll win. It's a game changer. Party over for whoever doesn't sign me. I said, I'm not making threats. I'm not sitting here. I don't care. You ask me what's going to happen. You ask me a question, I'll give you an answer. And that was it. And I was right. XM gone. Sirius XM now. Sirius forcing a merger. And everything came to fruition just as we said. And so here it is, 4 years later, in four short years. Now, in four short years, would you have think that this company would be one merged company with 19 million subscribers?
Absolutely not. That could not have been seen from that vantage point.
They call this new company SiriusXM, but what's the difference? What do you call it? Call it company JFK, whatever you want to call it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Call it whatever you want. This new company has 19 million subscribers and has turned the profit when everyone laughed and said it wouldn't work. And it's working. The new company exists and it's whole. And Sirius One. That's it. Game plan, as I stated in that meeting, you will win if you hire me. And they did. And that's it, because we don't lose. We got a good attitude and we know what we do and we know our product. And so this perhaps final chapter in my career is the most satisfying of all. If I was a lunatic, I would go back to terrestrial radio and revive terrestrial radio to keep this saga going.
Oh, no.
But I don't have it in me to fight the FCC anymore. I just don't. I don't want to do it.
That was horrible.
Yeah.
The conditions we were living under were horrible.
Yep. I was walking on a beach this weekend where I happened upon a seal. And I'm looking at the seal. How many times do you have that? He came out of the water. It looked like a fat Hawaiian tourist.
Wearing a shirt.
And nothing gave me more pleasure than to sit there and look at this seal and talk to the seal and wonder where he came from and what his life is like. And then I saw him go back into the ocean after he sunned himself. And I said, nothing's better than that. If that's the rest of my life, sitting on a beach watching the seals, I'll be fine. Because I know in my heart, the promise I made to this company was kept. They wanted to win. They wanted to be the champion. And if they hired me, what would happen? They asked me for a prediction. I told them what would happen. XM dead. Sirius wins. Game over.
You're not leaving the job undone.
The job was finished. And there'll be people who will go down and say, I'm some kind of nut or lunatic loser motherfucker. But it's not the case. Everywhere we went, we made the companies we work for win. And the companies have to treat you fairly when you win. If you make good on your promise and you do it, they better fucking do the right thing by you. And if they don't, fuck them. Go back and ruin them. That's what I say. CBS Radio screwed me. Screw you. You can't even find a morning show. Good. Die. Radio division profits off 53%. There's my fake laugh, Fred. It's better than yours.
Mine's not fake.
Whatever it is. I don't know. Whatever it is, it's fine with me. Like John Lennon said, I'll just sit there and watch the wheels go round and round. I don't care. Substitute the word seals for wheels. I'm just sitting here watching the seals go round and round. I don't care. But a lot of these companies don't want to do right by you when you deliver the goods.
Sometimes they resent you.
They resent you. They'll fight you. They'll legally wrangle you.
They don't want to give you the credit.
They don't want to give you the credit. They don't even want to give you what's in your contract. You know that? They'll play legal games with you. But I kept my word. This company is one spectacular company now that has been overhauled, and the merger happened because of one reason and one reason only, this show. That's it. As predicted. You know, that's it. Just remember that. There's a couple of people I'm talking to. Just remember that. Talking to you, Steve. You seem to have a short memory. So mission accomplished, Robin. Congratulations.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you. I mean...